A quick review of Goose Island IPA. So this one is 5.9% alcohol. And this one, it says beer company, but it's IPA. IPA, Goose Island. You see Goose? I did drink, I think in Hawaii, it's called Goose Island beer. So sometimes you can find beer, but sometimes you can find the IPA. IPA means International Pale Ale, but this one say India Pale Ale. This one, India Pale Ale. Actually, the first time I've tried IPA was in Hawaii, maybe 10 years ago. Before that, I never had a chance actually to try. But in Hawaii, they have Kona Brewery, and they have like Big Wave, or Longboard, or different beers, I guess. But some of it says IPA or pale ale. But anyway, for those who don't know what is IPA, it's basically beside wheat or hops, whatever is like bread, like suppose dark bread and white bread and oats or rye, which is normally used for beer. So beside that, for IPA, they can use different plants like pine tree or different trees or bushes, leaves, herbs. So it's not really always grains from the fields, you know. So the good thing about IPA, first of all, they can achieve like say 5.9% or higher, because some of those plants are given more alcohol than grains. And this is not really like going through distillation, it's just a natural way that they can get alcohol. Now, another good thing is IPA can be gluten-free. Somewhat you can find gluten-free. So gluten is considered bad for some people. If you have like prescription to eat gluten-free, it's better don't drink beer. But you find IPA, which is gluten-free IPA. So I did drink this before. It's quite good. My favorite actually would be Hawaiian IPA. They have few Hawaiian IPAs from Kona, and I like this one, and Samuel Adams. Samuel Adams is making IPA. So let's see. It's good. It's quite good. But some of it have like a little bit of citrus. I like a little bit with citrus. But all it's always like, it's possible just have lime or lemon, add lime or lemon to it. That's my choice. In California, it is quite often that you can find India Pale Ale. To find gluten-free is a little bit more difficult, but I've seen some of it. It says gluten-free. And then also I like Sierra Nevada. Sierra Nevada is from, I believe, Northern California, somewhere like close to Sacramento, somewhere there. So I would say Sierra Nevada. When I was in Hawaii, I was drinking a lot of Sierra Nevada. In Hawaii, you can order Sierra Nevada just like beer. Like if you go to, say, they have Turtle Bay. I went to Turtle Bay Resort, and they have a bar, and you can order beer. At the same time, you can order Sierra Nevada, which is IPA considered. So what I say, what I can say, I like it. This is actually almost double of some beers, because beer, like many beers, like 3% alcohol. This is almost 5.9. So you don't need to drink as much, and it has like very rich taste IPA. I would say if the best one is like 5, I would consider this like close to 5. I don't think out of many I would say the best, but let's say this is 4.6. 4.6 out of 5. I would consider a Hawaiian IPA. I like some of them better than this one. They put more things, it has certain other taste. I would put citrus actually, maybe lime or lemon, something with that. Anyway, overall, it's pretty good. I would recommend. Have a good time, bye.